is myself Umesh Kumar Sharma from Arya College of Engineering and IT. Today we are going to discuss the topic wet etching, dry etching, plasma etching and anisotropic etching. Introduction of etching. After photoresist image has been formed on the surface of a bulb, the next process involves transferring the image into the layer under resist by etching. Etching is a process by which material is removed normally selectively in RC technology. The mechanism by which material is removed may be physical, chemical or combination of the two. It is generally true to say that the greater the degree of chemical activity, the greater is the selectivity that can be achieved. In other words, by a suitable choice of reactant, it is usually possible to etch or react selectivity with one material while being inert with respect to another. An alternative method of classification would be dry and wet etching. In dry etching, the buffer is attacked or bombarded by ions, radicals or atoms in the vapor phase. Plasma processes are extensively used today for dry etching. In wet etching, liquid chemicals are used and so the mechanism is entirely chemical. In wet etching, a lot of buffer are loaded onto a quartz holder and dipped into a bath containing liquid chemicals. The materials to be etched is attacked by the chemicals. In conventional wet etching, strong acid like hydrochloride HF are used to etch semiconductor buffer, followed by cleaning with high quality deionized water. The resulting products are liquid or gaseous and dissolved in the bath solution. Note that this is a bath process and therefore has large throughput. In dry etching, the process can be partially or totally physical. In such case, the substrate or buffer is subjected to ion or natural particle bombardment either in a plasma environment or by scanning of a focused ion beam. In either case, the process is carried out in vacuum chamber. Dry etching offers significant advantage in terms of fine line width control and greater anisotropicity. In purely physical process, the etching is carried out by the bombardment of the buffer to be etched with inert ions. Often a combination of physical and chemical mechanism can be employed. This is done by using reactive ion species rather than inert ions. Thus, we can classify the dry etching process into two classes, plasma-based and ion beam-based process. Sputter ion etching refers to case where natural ions are used for etching in a plasma environment. The system here physically identical to an RF sputtering unit, with the buffer being placed on the opposite electrode to that of sputter deposition. If a reactive ion species are used for etching, it is called reactive ion etching or RIE. Anisotropic dry etching process are concerned, RIE is the most commonly used in device etching today. There exists a third possibility, the plasma may be used to merely treat the required chemical species, while the process itself is purely chemical. This is commonly called plasma etching. While the different forms of dry etching are carried out under low pressure partial vacuum, the etching itself in plasma etchers takes place under under normal atmospheric pressure. Figure of merits. First is etch rate. Etch rate refers to the rate of removal of selective material. It is defined as thickness per unit time. Through high etch rate is desirable, but it renders a process difficult to control also. Batch processing results in reduced etch rate. The uniformity of etch rate is measured in terms of percentage variation of etch rate. Second is selectivity. Selectivity patterns to the ability of the etchant or etching system to attack the desired material layer while at the same time not attacking or affecting other material present on the buffer. In general, all chemical techniques are intrinsically more selective than physically processed. In other words, if different materials are bombarded by ions, a certain amount of sputtering would take place depending on the molecular weights of the material involved. On the other hand, chemicals can be highly specific in their reaction. One material may be very strongly attacked by one chemical species, whereas another material could be completely unaffected. Selectivity is the ratio of each rate of various materials. Next is uniformity. Uniformity to the etch rate of same material in different sections of the water or different buffers. Ideally, thus should be the same everywhere. However, fluid flow patterns in the etching bath or reactor and other projects may cause non-uniform etch rates. A related parameters pattern selectivity is a measure of the difference in etch rate depending on features such as design on the mask pattern and must also be low. Next is throughput. An important aspect to remember at this point is the concept of throughput, which is a measure of the time it takes to process a lot of buffers. Batch processes are those in which an entire lot of buffers is processed together. Obviously, throughput in such case is very high. Example of such process are diffusion and wet etching. Global or buffer process are those where the process is done essentially one buffer at a time. Example, mask alignment, where one buffer at a time has to be aligned. Obviously, the throughput is much lower in this case. Plasma based process fall in this category. Plasma etching, reactive ion etching, and sputter etching. Alternatively, there are local or beam scanned process where the processing is done by traversing it. Obviously, the processing here through possibly far more accurate is likely to be much slower. Ion beam process like ion milling and RIBE fall in this category. Next is anisotropy. Anisotropy pertains to the ability of the etchant to attack the lower in a directed manner. Two distinct mechanisms normally coexist in the etching process in SIC technology, namely chemical etching, which is essentially isotropic, and ionic etching, which is directed, or anisotropic, the directivity being provided by the directed electric field. In final and VLSI fabrication, the latter could be extremely important. For example, consider the situation where each groove is to be etched on a buffer. If the each end is isotropic, the each end while acting vertically downwards on the specified area would also tend to etch the material laterally. As a result, the groove width etched would be different and larger than the designed dimension. In a plasma etching process, if the removal is primarily by physical bombardment, sputtering, the etching could be highly directional, determined by the direction of the electric field accelerating the bombarding ions. On the other hand, in a chemical process, the etching is generally isotropic. The sketch in figure shows the result one expects with the different degrees of anisotropicity. It should be apparent that with greater anisotropicity, the fidelity with respect to the mask dimension is greater. In isotropic etching, the result could show a degree of undercutting. Difference between the wet and dry etching. Wet and dry etching. Wet etching systems are in use in low and silicon processing today. Even though there is a continuously increasing trend to replace the same by dry etching technologies. Obviously, this is due to the fact that wet etching continues to offer several significant advantages. Perhaps the most significant being that batch immersion is possible. Thus, a large number of buffers can be handled simultaneously, often utilizing some degree of equipment automation. In chemical etching, the etchants used are essentially wet, in other words, in solution form. The analysis in this case proceeds along similar lines as in deposition, with the following significant differences. First is the reactions are essentially heterogeneous liquid solid reactions. Second is molar concentration in the solution rather than the partial pressure of the reactant is the relevant parameters. Third is that each product are essentially fluids. As in deposition process, there are two discrete mechanisms limiting the rate of etching, namely the reaction rate and the diffusion rate. In reaction rate limited etching, the etchant species react the target etching surface in unlimited amount, and the each stage is controlled by the rate of reactant at the surface. Alternatively, in diffusion limited etching, the mass transport of the etchant species to the target etching surface is limited, and the each rate is limited by the mass transfer or diffusion mechanism. Consider, for example, the case of etching of silicon by a mixture of HF, hydrofluoride, and HNO3. With acetic acid or NH4F acting as a moderator to control the pH of the etching solution. The HNO3 acts as an oxidizing agent which reacts with the silicon or silicon to form its oxide. The oxide is then etched by the HF. If the HNO3 is in excess, the oxidation rate is limited by the diffusion of the oxidant species in HNO3 through the oxide analogous to the thermal oxidation model. In the converged case, the etch rate of the oxide determines the overall etch rate. कंपैरिजन होता है करेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ वेट एंड ड्राई इचिंग प्रॉपर्टीज एनिसोट्रोपिसिटी नो केमिकल रिएक्शन यूजली आइसोट्रॉपिक एंड देयरफॉर पुअर लाइन डेफिनेशन इन ड्राई इचिंग यस फिजिकल डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ आयन बीम गिव्स डायरेक्टिविटी एंड देयरफॉर एक्सीडेंट एक्सीलेंट फाइन लाइन डेफिनेशन सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी इज थ्रूपुट एंड वेट इचिंग हाई इनहेरेंटली वेज मोड एंड ड्राई इचिंग लो इंडिविजुअल बफर प्रोसेस थर्ड इज प्रॉपर्टी सेलेक्टिविटी एंड वेट इचिंग सेलेक्टिविटी इज हाई एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन चॉइस ऑफ ईच एंड सेलेक्टिविटी इन ड्राई इचिंग इज लो फिजिकली बॉम्बार्डमेंट हैज पुअर सेलेक्टिविटी नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इन्फेक्शन इन वेट इचिंग इन्फेक्शन इज हाई थ्रू वेज इन वेज प्रोसेसिंग एंड ड्राई इचिंग इन्फेक्शन इज लो हाई वैक्यूम ऑपरेशन हैज प्रोन टू कंटेमिनेशन करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ वेट इचिंग वेट इचिंग एप्लीकेशन इन सिलिकॉन टेक्नोलॉजी कैन बी ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड इन टू थ्री ग्रुप्स फर्स्टली वेट इचिंग यूज टू बी extensively used for selective etching of buffer during lithography. In this process, a photoresist is coated onto a buffer containing several layers of insulating, often SiO2, semiconducting, usually polysilicon or metallic layer for the purpose of selectivity, removing the uppermost layer. Subsequently, the patterned photoresist is selectively removed and then the underlying layer. Now the topmost layer is etched. The normal requirement here is that while the topmost exposed layer of the buffer must be attacked by the agent, neither the layer below nor the photoresist must be attacked. Of course, in lift off photolithography, advantage is taken of lateral etching by the agent. Secondly, wet chemicals are also used for non-selectively etching or cleaning of silicon buffers. The third group of applications pertains to the cleaning of associated glassware or waterware cleaning. In the latter two groups, wet chemical process seem to the only practical solution. Introduction of plasma etching. Etching techniques are classified into two classes: wet etching using liquid etchant and dry etching involving plasma. In dry etching, the reaction energy could be primarily chemical. Due to the example creation of natural atomic species, we can thus expect that the etching in this case to be primarily isotropic. This is normally referred to as plasma etching. During the plasma process, the target buffers are bombarded by several energetic ionic species. The interaction with the buffer can be either a chemical reaction, a physical interaction, or in general both the bombardment by inert ions like Ar+ could cause the material to be sputtered. If the bombarding species is a reactive ion, both sputtering and chemical reaction could take place and the material removal could be done to a combination of the two mechanisms. In plasma etching, the buffers are induced into a plasma environment created by a gas mix. The plasma etching process is an extremely complex one with a large number of different physical and chemical processes simultaneously taking place. For case of understanding, we will simplify the overall etching process into two parts, a physical sputtering process and a set of chemical reaction. It must be remembered. Thus, we see that the plasma here perform the following key rules. First is the electrons present in the plasma assist in the formation of new ionic radical which could otherwise not be created. Second is the electron present in the plasma disassociated gas molecules, example O2 atomic species, example O, oxygen, which are then responsible for the etching reactions. The electrons and ions present in the plasma giving rise to the formation of new molecules and radicals which otherwise would be possible. The plasma environment assists in the continued presence of reactive species like O, F, etc. In the above, the plasma assists in the chemical reactivity of the gas mix reacting with the buffer. As well, the careful choice of the gas mixture should give a reaction can be initiated or suppressed as desired. The complexity of the process aids in the formation of a large number of species through a large number of intermediate reactions. Often the exact metric on the creation of the different species is unknown. Plasma reaction takes place at a certain engineering lower temperature. This is due to several reasons. Firstly, the plasma creates high energy particles for the reaction, which essentially means little external thermal energy needs to be supplied. Also, this is because new species of lifetime are created, which can react at much lower temperature. Plasma contains energetic ions which can be used to attack the buffer in a direct manner by the electric field. The plasma can also give rise to several deleterious effects in the plasma fusion process. Various radiations like X-ray are generated, which can reduce the reliability of the device fabricated in the chip. The buffer is also bombarded by several different species which can give rise to unwanted and undesired effect. Requirement of plasma etching. Three important requirements in etching are selectivity, anisotropy and uniformity. A very large number of species are created within plasma. As a result, the degree of specificity of the reaction strength that we produce in a wet chemical process is considerably reduced, and so the degree of selectivity in a plasma process is relatively poor. So endpoint detection techniques have to be necessary employed in plasma etching system. Advantage of plasma etching on wet etching. First, if plasma etching has more control on each route than wet etching. Second, if plasma etching is easier to start and stop than wet etching. Third, if plasma etching is less sensitive to temperature change. Fourth, if plasma etching has high anisotropics and it also has fewer particles than wet etching. Fifth, if in plasma etching much less chemical waste is reduced compared to wet etching. Process of plasma etching. In plasma etching process proceed in a chamber in which a feed gas is introduced and the gas must be broken down into the chemically reactive species like plasma solution. Then the reaction product are dissolved, diffused away from buffer and carried away by gas stream out of each chamber. In this process, the etching is determined by first step involved. The most widely used product for producing the plasma is carbon chloride. Let us consider that CF4 is allowed to flow inside the chamber in which high pressure of 500 mPa is maintained. The sealer buffer with photoresist mask comes in contact with plasma and eats the silicon substrate. The says that etching can take place if a gaseous or high pressure liquid or solid is energetically favored and produced by chemical reaction. Apply this idea for silicon etching requires the replacement of SI bonds with SI halogen bonds. For breaking CF bonds in CF4 energy of 105 kilocalorie per mole is required, and for breaking silicon bond energy of 42.2 kilocalorie per mole is required. So for etching of silicon, some output energy 147 kilocalorie per mole must be less than energy of silicon SIF bond 130 kilocalorie per mole. It can be understood by following reaction.